Hi, I'm Hannah, and this is the first video of a series on particles.
So what is a particle?
Well, my phone defined it as a minute portion of matter, and we know that matter is a substance that takes up space and has mass.
Hold up. Photons are called particles all the time, but they don't have a mass.
Exactly. But it turns out that the definition of a particle is highly not agreed upon. So from now on, let's just refer to a particle as a minuscule object that can be categorized by several of its characteristics, such as charge, mass, spin, etc. Some particles exist as both a wave and a particle, in a wave-particle duality.
Some particles are just little packets of energy.
And some particles can literally not exist by themselves.
Hundreds of particles have been discovered, though many only exist for a brief amount of time.
They can be classified in an immense number of ways, but my most basic way of classifying them are in the following categories: macro particles, atomic particles, and subatomic particles.
Macro particles are things such as single grains of sand or little dust particles you see floating around your room when it's sunny out.
They're very tiny, but they're still ginormous compared to the particles in the other categories.
Atomic particles can be single atoms, and I'm willing to include small molecules and compounds in this category.
Examples of atomic particles would be a single molecule of water or a pure atom of gold.
And finally, we have subatomic particles.
They are the particles that are smaller than an atom and can range from ones you're probably very familiar with, such as a neutron or a proton, to ones you may have never heard of, like gravitons or quarks.
To me, subatomic particles are the most complex and intriguing, and they're exactly what we'll be covering in the next video.
Until then, I'm Hannah, and I hope you had a very happy holiday.